to start off, really wanting to make sure we're all on the same page, I'm kind of going back to the very basics and saying, what is palliative care? And giving you a working definition of what we currently view as the state of palliative care and that its specialty. So palliative care, there's a term, has evolved. So there has been a lot of misperception out there about what it means. A lot of that due to the historical associations with hospice and end-of-life care. But that is not what palliative care is. Palliative care is a specialized medical care for people with serious illness. It's a type of care that's focused on providing patients with relief from the symptoms, pain, and stress of a serious illness, whatever the diagnosis. What I'm sharing with you with regards to this definition is really based on the work of the American Cancer Society Action Network and the Center to Advance Palliative Care in defining palliative care with language that was accessible and really comprehensive for what it entails. So the primary goal in palliative care is to improve the quality of life for both the patient and the family. I highlight this aspect of palliative care because the emphasis on the patient and family together as the unit of care is essential and really represents the comprehensive approach that palliative care takes in addressing issues around quality of life. Another very key aspect about palliative care is the multidisciplinary nature of the specialty, that it is provided by a team of clinicians that includes doctors, nurses, as well as other specialists like social work, who work with a patient's other clinicians, other providers, to give that extra layer of support. It is a type of care that can be provided together with curative treatment. It is not an either-or situation. It's a both-and. Moving on to what our major key cancer organizations say with regards to palliative care, the first organization I wanted to highlight was the American Society of Clinical Oncology. They recently, as recent as February of this year, released a position paper with regards to recommendations on the integration of palliative care. The first part of their statement revolves specifically around care for patients who have a metastatic non-small cell lung cancer. This statement is based on a randomized control trial that was published in 2010 by Jennifer Temel and colleagues at the Massachusetts General Hospital. Their trial randomized patients with metastatic non-small cell lung cancer to standard oncologic care from the point of initial diagnosis, and another group to that standard oncologic care plus concurrent palliative care. So palliative care was provided at the same time as that oncologic care. And what that consisted of was a monthly visit with a palliative care clinician while that patient was receiving their standard oncologic treatment and care for their metastatic non-small cell lung cancer. The trial looked at specific outcomes related to quality of life, depression, and appropriate utilization of hospice care. And in all those different domains, the experience of patients who received the concurrent palliative care was better. So they had better quality of life scores, less depression, more appropriate use of hospice. The one outcome that they also looked at that was strikingly positive and beneficial for patients who received concurrent palliative care was that those patients also survived longer. There was about an additional 3 months that those patients lived beyond those who just received standard oncologic care. This really was a revolutionizing outcome and I think really altered the perspective and views of clinicians looking at the intervention of palliative care and also the power of such an approach to care coming alongside standard care. So this position paper also looked at several other studies that provided substantial evidence demonstrating the benefits of palliative care, both for the patient and also for caregivers. Again, hearkening back to that emphasis in the definition of palliative care on a patient and their family or caregivers as the unit of care. So their major consensus statement came to the consensus that combined standard oncology care and palliative care should be considered early in the course of illness for any patient with metastatic cancer and or a high symptom burden. So even if a patient were to have a early stage cancer but a lot of symptoms, symptoms like pain, nausea, depression, etc., that those patients should also be considered for combined standard oncology care and palliative care. So what other cancer organizations have said is comparable to what ASCO has recently published. So the NCCN, the National Comprehensive Cancer Network, recently released a statement saying that palliative care should be available on-site or by referral. More specific than that in terms of what that entails, how many team members, what services, how much should they be available, etc. But there was that kind of statement released comparable to what ASCO is saying for offering concurrent palliative care. The Quality Oncology Practice Initiative, which is a program administered by ASCO, has come up with quality measures to gauge how high quality the care is delivered by different cancer centers and really giving a standard that all cancer centers can be compared on. And several of these quality measures revolve around good palliative care practices and principles, including the assessment and treatment of pain early in the course of care. And very specific measure, as an example, is that the QAPI measures state that patients should, by their second visit, have had an assessment of pain documented. Another quality measure that QAPI initiative has proposed is timely and appropriate referrals to hospice, so patients get very high quality care in that stage of illness as well. So what does this mean for patients and families? And really, what are the key questions that patients and families, caregivers, will want to ask in considering the availability of palliative care as a resource? One would be, does my oncology clinic or cancer center have a palliative care team or a program? And if so, how can I access them? Does my oncologist need to put in a referral? Is there a phone line that I can call? Can I make an appointment, etc.? What are other services that are available that offer support? Do we have a psycho-oncology section or division? Psycho-oncology is a specialty now within psychiatry that focuses on the mental health and coping for patients who have a cancer diagnosis. Other services may include social work, or financial counseling, case management. These are all components to consider with regards to additional support. I will note here that it's very highly variable from site to site and even country to country. In the United States, the system of providing support services is quite different from, say, even the system right over the border in Canada, where they have cancer rehabilitation and nutrition, which is an umbrella that encompasses a lot of these support services, where that doesn't kind of exist in that form in the U.S.
Thanks for listening. If you like and learn from our Gracecasts, you can subscribe on iTunes by just searching for the term Cancer Grace, find podcasts and the subject you want, pick a format of audio or video, and then just click subscribe. It's that easy. And for those of you who don't want to miss any of our programs, there's even a feed for all subjects. You can also find us on YouTube at Grace for Cancer Info, and that's the number 4 in one word, Grace for Cancer Info. Finally, if you haven't been there yet, please check out our Grace website at www.cancergrace.org. And don't forget that donate button in the upper right. Our content, which helps tens of thousands of cancer patients around the world every month, is made possible by your support. Thanks again.